My name is Bob Derr from SAS Institute, and I am going to talk about partial proportional odds modeling. This video is based on a SAS Global Forum paper I gave in 2013, which you can find online. The data are collected from pregnant women reporting back pain. Their responses are in the severity variable, where smaller values indicate more severe pain. The predictors found by Chatfield are trimester, a categorical variable, and log of age, a continuous variable. Since the response has three response levels that are ordered, we'll try fitting a proportional odds model. ProcLogistic fits the proportional odds model by default. Here we're just using main effects. The cumulative logits are the logs of worse severity versus less severity. For the linear predictors, the intercepts for the two functions are different, but the slopes are the same. We'll fill in the covariates soon. Now we'll look at ProcLogistic's output. The first tables let you verify that you're fitting what you think you are. We have three response levels and are using cumulative logits. And the note below the response profile table means you have cumulative logits. You can see we have five parameters, two intercepts, alpha-1 and alpha-2, and the three slopes, beta-1, beta-2, and beta-3, that are shared between the two response functions. With a general linear predictor, we would have two complete sets of slopes for a total of eight parameters. But ProcLogistic tests the proportional odds assumption and rejects the null that the proportional odds model is adequate as compared to the more general model with eight parameters. This test actually rejects too often. If it does not reject the assumption, then you're fine. If it does reject, then you still may be able to justify using the proportional odds in other ways. I'm going to show you two graphical methods to attempt a justification. You can compute the empirical cumulative logits for your response functions against each covariate individually, and the curves ought to be roughly parallel. Here, trimester fails miserably, but log of age looks fairly parallel, so it can satisfy the proportional odds. Similarly, you can plot the expected value of each predictor against the response levels under a proportional odds model for each covariate individually, and compare that curve to the empirical means. If the proportional odds assumption is okay, then these should be somewhat parallel. Again, trimester really fails, but log age does not. So I want to fit a model where trimester is a general effect with different parameters in different response functions, but log of age is a proportional odds effect with a common parameter across the response functions. To do this in ProcLogistic, we added an unequal slopes option to the model statement several years ago in SAS Stat 12.1. It can replace some or all of the slope parameters in a proportional odds model. Watch the trimester parameters, with more general parameters specific to each response function. A couple years later, in SAS Stat 13.2, we added an equal slopes option to do something similar for the generalized logit model. The left-hand side of these functions is the generalized logit, and by default, this model has a complete set of parameters for each response function. The equal slopes option can change some or all of the general predictors, watch the log age parameter, to be proportional odds predictors. And you can use these two options together. So let's start with our default proportional odds model program and add unequal slopes equals trimester, so that trimester now has a separate set of slope parameters for each of the two response functions. We now have seven parameters in the model. And we'll compute odds ratios as well. The model information tells you that you're fitting a partial proportional odds model. These are the usual tests that ProcLogistic produces to test that various sets of parameters are jointly zero. They're all rejected, which is good, and we can move on to the parameter estimates. Log age only has one parameter shared between the response functions, so it has only one row. And when you write the model, the log age parameter is 1.767 in both response functions. But trimester has two sets of parameters, as indicated by the severity column. To interpret the odds ratios, since log age is a proportional odds effect, you can summarize the results by saying more severe pain. But trimester is split up by function, so you have to distinguish the odds ratios according to the response function. You should perform goodness of fit tests for your model. One way is to compare your model with a larger expanded model by using likelihood ratio tests. The LR test macro lets you specify the larger model as model 1 and the smaller as model 2. But first, I want to perform some other tests. This first test corresponds to the score test of the proportional odds assumption we showed earlier. It compares a model with two complete sets of parameters, so that's eight parameters, by using the unequal slopes option. to the original proportional odds model that has 5 parameters. The p-value says we reject the null that the smaller proportional odds model is adequate. We compare our model to the proportional odds model, and again we reject the null that the smaller proportional odds model is adequate. Compare our model to the a-parameter one, where log h also has separate slopes, and we do not reject the adequacy of our partial proportional odds model. Finally, for goodness of fit testing, you want the expanded model to include interactions and squared terms, and we'll beef it up even more by specifying both equal slopes and unequal slopes. These are the response functions for the expanded model. The equal slopes terms are in black and have the same parameters in both functions. The covariates are repeated as unequal slope terms in red with different parameters in the different functions. Essentially, the equal slope terms are fitting a global mean while the unequal slope terms are deviations from that mean. For our test, we are comparing our model, which contains all the terms in red, to the expanded model, which involves every term. And we do not reject the null that our model is adequate, but there may be some structure there since the p-value is pretty small. We pieced this model together ourselves. You could also let ProcLogistic's standard selection methods do the work for you. To do this, specify your model, specify both equal and unequal slopes, and specify a selection method. And in this case, we end up selecting the same model. The unequal slope parameters are prefixed with a U here. You can find the original paper and programs in the 2013 SAS Global Forum proceedings, but it does not mention the equal slopes option. Stokes, Davis, and Cook also discuss partial proportional odds modeling. You can get more information about this and a lot of other topics at support.sas.com/statistics. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you have learned a little bit about partial proportional odds modeling.